Russia is part of North America. I know what you're thinking. This smart aleck on YouTube is telling me there's some iceberg just off the coast of Canada in the Arctic Ocean that the Russians claimed by putting some vodka and a Kalashnikov next to a polar bear. But no. We'll get back to that in a bit. You might have already had the question, what continent is Russia in? You may think Europe and Asia are the only options, but it's just not that simple. North America is an acceptable option, along with a number of others. You're probably familiar with the seven continents. In Russia, where does the border between Europe and Asia lay? Give any kid a map and a crayon and tell them to draw a line that goes from up to down in this general area, and you'll get an acceptable answer. This is exactly how people have drawn the border throughout history, with the help of rivers and mountains. Since a continent is often defined as being a large landmass separated by an ocean, and I don't know about you, but I don't see any ocean here, how are Europe and Asia separate continents? Well, that's complicated, so some people call it Eurasia for simplicity's sake. Except there's no such thing as simplicity in this case. There's this and that, so people call this Afro-Eurasia. Remember the story about the Kalashnikov and the bear? Yeah, it's still made up. Anyways, Russia is part of North America. Why? Science. Because science is there to give us answers. Future episode, hint hint. In geology, continents are tectonic plates on a large landmass. Most of the plates are properly named according to their location, even the ones you probably don't recognize. Except one. The North American plate. This plate is just plain weird. It contains most of mainland North America, including the Canadian Arctic, polar bears yes, Kalashnikov and vodka no. It also contains Greenland and some of the Caribbean islands, along with half of Iceland, half of Japan, and a decent chunk of Russia that's bigger than a dinky iceberg. Or a lot of things, in fact. It encompasses a lot of land, and a lot of bears, but not a whole lot of people. While the rest of Russia, with most of the population, of humans and bears, is in the Eurasian plate. Part of Russia being in the North American plate also makes sense when you think about the land bridge across the Bering Strait thousands of years ago, where people crossed from Asia into the Americas. One of the possible places where people first entered the Americas. So next time someone asks, what continent is Russia in? Tell them there are five acceptable answers. Europe, Asia, Eurasia, Afro-Eurasia, and North America, and that it may or may not be transcontinental, depending on your answer or answers. And go tell them to watch this video. All of this is further proof that even the most seemingly obvious questions can have answers you never expected. Russia uses the Russian ruble as its currency, while the United States uses the US dollar. Most of Europe uses the euro. All of these currencies, along with many others, use coins, but the usage of coins is fading away. Most people find coins annoying and stupid. Click here to watch the video about the potential extinction of coins. Go on,